Hello friends, welcome to our channel AgriWizard BAU. Today we have brought you a video on various stress that a college student face in their life. Today we have with us on this video Mr. Avnish Mishra, who has done BA MA from Clinical Psychology and has done internship with Max Hospital and various government hospital and NGOs, and is currently working with Project Step 1 for Delhi government. Do watch the video till the end, as all the aspects will unfold one by one and you will be able to correlate with them accordingly. Before we begin the video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe our channel. So let's begin this video.
College stress. Generally, what people have reported to me while I was working with different organizations and interning under them, looking at the student section in particular, The general stresses that people have reported are tabulated here. I mean, I have taken care of a couple of them. Clearly, about nearly 47% is what I have the data. 47% students find something or the other stressful in their college life. Primary of which is transition. Transition from not just transition. I mean, particularly from school to college, because your entire method of how you are going about your studies changes. In school, we are spoon-fed with the notes, with the assignments, the tests, the syllabus, and everything. While in college, none of it is taken care. We need to make our notes by ourselves. We need to take down the assignments. We need to submit the assignments on time. The teachers won't repeatedly come to you, ki beta de do assignment, like in schools. But here, we need to put out the things in perspective much earlier than we do in school. So we need to take care of this part. How we can take care of the transition is, one, while in school, we need to prepare ourselves for moving to college. What we don't do is that we stay in this zone most of our school life, even in the 11th and 12th. We stay in this zone. We have friends, we move around, we study, we catch up in a good college. But then we haven't really prepared ourselves for college life. We don't know how things be. Neither does our education system prepare us. But that does fall into place. So we need to prepare ourselves from moving from this zone so that it helps us to have a perspective how a college life would be. And how can we do that? We can prepare our notes in advance. We can stop thinking about how college life would be, stop romanticizing it. People have romanticized college life a lot because of the Bollywood movies showing it in a very different light. However, it is not the same. Moving on to the next one, which is again a very common one, financial stress. Financial stress, why I say is a very common stress, because most of us entering college life aren't very financially sound. We have pocket money for sure. We have, because, but after spending a lot of money on our stay, on our food, on our tuition and everything else, there's very little left with us. We need to take care of that too. That's a big stress in college days for students. So nearly about 28% of students fall short of finances, and they commit something or the other due to financial stress. That is how we need to take it. If you look at how the financial growth is in college, it's never like this. It's never a growing graph. It's always something like this. You have it or you don't have it. You have money sometimes, but you spend it across on something or the other. Some new relationships occur. We start spending money and all of that happens. But we need to take care of the financial part too, because if you're not financially sound, at times you might get stressed because of a lot of things. You might need something at an urgent basis, which you might not get because of the financial strain that you are in. So we can look for alternative part-time jobs, which is a very common thing in the international forum, which Indians generally do not do. There are a lot of websites where you can, work as a content writer, as different things. A lot of things that are available to us in current scenario. So you can search. There are websites like Internshala and everything. They provide internships, paid internships, which is a very different thing than what I have done. Academic stress is something that you and I, both of us, I mean, most of us have gone through. The syllabus has changed. Our entire method of learning has changed. We are not being spoon-fed. We are not being given notes. We are not being given the syllabus. We have not, it's nothing like a regular test sort of. We have a midterm, we have an end term. But the problem is that we don't know we don't have a defined syllabus in college, usually. Defined syllabus as in we have 10 things and we don't need to read all of that. You know, we need just 6 of them. The rest 4 are there just for your elimination as in. Elimination here means just so that you score less. I mean, scoreless has been it's not that the teachers want you to score less, it's that they want to prepare you for competitions ahead. Competitions ahead are always on an elimination basis. So we don't have a defined syllabus in college, is what I say. That's why I say that we need to read the syllabus more and more. The more we read the syllabus, we understand what is to be read and what is not to be read. And in college, a lot of the questions are always repeated. Previous year questions are a must to be read in college, because I have seen this. Most of the questions are repeated from the previous year because the syllabus isn't changing. It's not as dynamic as people see it to be. So that's one thing we can always take care of, syllabus part, that will reduce our academic stress. We need to also engage ourselves in more recreational activities like singing or whatever we do. Many people open up a YouTube channel. Many often end up doing something with their writing. A lot of people discover their writing talent while in college, which is a very good thing to express. Then comes the situational stress. Situational stress is nothing more than what it seems to be with the term itself. While a presentation is happening, you're done with your presentation, and then you are asked anything specifically by the teacher, you get stressed because you've seen that all the attention is on you, and the people are eyeing you and wanting you to make mistakes, which is not the case. People may be wanting anything, that's not none of your concern. Your concern is more how to deal with that particular situation. When situational stress occurs, we often, our brain fades. We often lose control on what we were doing, what we were thinking, whatever we were presenting, and all. We need to calm ourselves down. We need to give ourselves a minute. 1 minute can help us change a lot of things. We can recall what we were supposed to tell. We can frame our sentences better. We can often end up being better than what we could, even if we weren't asked that question. So we can always end up increasing our capability, and our growth lies in these situational stresses. As always, I always say that situational stresses always, enhance your characteristics, enhance your personality in dealing with impromptu situations. A lot of people in their college days resort to this substance abuse. Any form, maybe alcohol, maybe drug abuse, cigarettes, tobacco, anything, weed, a lot of things that they resort to so that they can run away from the stress that they are going through. But does that really happen? Does this help you reduce your stress levels? Temporarily, maybe it does. But in the long run, it will only increase. It will never decrease. It will always increase. And this will have side effects to sleeping problems, concentration problems, and a lot more. You cannot focus on things because you are always, into the thought of that substance. At times, you also want to quit. Like if you look at this picture, you want to quit, but you cannot because it wants this. It wants the substance that you have been using because somehow, if you have been addicted to it, because you are getting the temporary benefits in your mind. So you need to get off all of this substance abuse. Why? Because if you continue with the substance abuse, you can never get over it. So if you want to get off the thing, you need to do a lot of things. One If the intensity is high, consider a rehabilitation center. There's no harm in a rehabilitation center, as contrary to the general opinion. You can consider meditation, which is a very known method to curb the use of substance abuse. You can also go for yoga practices. All of this does nothing but helps you be more in control of your mind than you actually are at the moment. What this does, this helps you gain control of, if you really want to have this, or you're just having this because you are running away from some temporary stress. Stress is temporary, right? We can fight this if the situations, we can change the situations we are in. Then comes placement. As I have seen, most of the colleges, when turn to placements, when we turn to placements in colleges, most of the IT sector, in fact, in particular, complains of not having skilled labor. They are hiring people, but they aren't hiring people who are as skilled as they should be when they are in job from their college. Now, fields like agriculture too. Agriculture has a lot of demand in the country, but due to some circumstances, the governments aren't hiring people. Maybe shortage of fund or some politics. Or, I don't know. I want to comment on that part. But agriculture has a lot of potential in it in the country, because we are an agrarian-based economy still. A large chunk of it is, which is why we need more skilled laborers. Or in any field, we need more skilled laborers. Our gross enrollment ratio in higher education falls down to 25%, which is nearly around 94% in higher school education. So if we are falling from 94% to nearly 23%, which is a very big ratio, and that ratio needs to be sorted out. What we as students can do in while fearing or getting anxious about placement: one, always be prepared for the worst. Now, people tell me to not think negative, which is good, which is fine, but you should have a plan. You should have prepared your mind for even not getting the job you're applying for. If you don't get a job, doesn't mean that you are a loser or a failure. You're not. It's just that you didn't get that job. That's as simple as it can be. Now, what you can do? Apply for higher studies, which you may not have if you were in the job. And once you are in the job, when salary gets credited in your account on the first of the month, you tend to not go for higher studies in most cases. So you can go for higher studies. You can also do one more thing. Look out for jobs on your own. Be on the lookout for jobs. Why? Because it's not all the companies do not come to every college, right? But they are hiring. People are hiring. The private sector is hiring. The government sectors are hiring. It's possible that they miss out the college, or you might have ended up performing something. Something must have gone over the board, which didn't make you as capable as you were in the moment. And you didn't fare well in the interview or whatever the examination pattern was for the placement. But the same company can hire you later. A lot of times that has happened, the company has not hired the student while in college. A year later, the same student applied for a higher position and he got the job. So we need to look out for the positives. We need to be sure about what we are doing and why we are doing. Placement is not everything. You need to know why you need to get placed, where you need to get placed, and what you need to do with your placement. So you need to have these things in mind. This is the general pattern that I have seen. If you have any questions, you can go through the, you can ask them, and I'll be happy to answer your questions.
Well, thank you, Mr. Avnish Mishra, for addressing the problems of students that they generally face in college. Since the today's situation, everyone is now trying to understand and face that whether they are in depression or stress or anything. They are ready to face now. But some of the students wanted to know that whether the society should be blamed or the institutional or academic institution should be blamed, or is it a personal thing, the stress, is it a personal or the society influence?
So if I am to be considered as someone who has an opinion on this, I say that it's about our perception of it. Why is it that in the same situation, A feels stressed while B is as happy as he can be? Right? A is stressed, B is not. The situation is the same, but the consequence is not the same. So it somewhere relates to our perception of the situation. If we change our challenge that we are facing to an opportunity, will we still get stressed? We won't, as I guess, because even if we consider the situation we are in of COVID, this is a challenge for all of us. It's a challenge for all of us to deal with this, to get more and more testing done, more and more vaccine trials being done. But this is also an opportunity. How it is an opportunity to regain yourself. Most of us are at home. We can find out something that we are creative at. All of us must have been complaining that I am missing out on my guitar sessions, or missing out on my singing sessions or dancing sessions. Because I'm not getting time from college. Right now, you are not in college. You are at home. So you can try these things. Which if even now you cannot pursue what you wanted to, then it's not about time. It's about you not wanting it. It's a partial hobby, or it's just a partial passion that we can call it. It's not your passion actually. So we need to change this part. We need to change the perception. How we perceive a situation defines what the situation is actually. If we perceive A to be challenging, it will be a challenging situation. If we take it as an opportunity, it will be an opportunity. And this will help us grow. Because challenges always help you grow. If you take them into opportunity, if you keep it as a challenge, then it's a decline. It will not help you grow, rather it will increase the level of stress that you are in.
Well, I would also like to bring into focus one more thing. That many students who are just in final semesters of whether UG or PG anything, they are in doubt that now the situation may demand less man skill and more machinery. So they are in doubt that whether their future is secured, or they will have to rush in a huge crowd to find a place for them. So this may also bring a stress. So what would you like to comment on this?
This surely can bring stress. I mean, apprehensions mostly bring stress. Now we are making an apprehension that things might get more machinery and hand skills, the human skills might become obsolete. But if you really look at the scenario, we are not sure about it as of now. Currently, nobody can conclude that human skills would be considered in less in as a potential than machine skills, because one, human skills cannot be compared to machine skills. Of course, the intensity and the speed at which machines work is far more than what humans work. But considering that as an apprehension would be a little too harsh on the environment, because being apprehensive about something that we are not really sure of, not really aware of, it would be more to, again, the perception part comes in. We don't know the things. Too early to comment on something which is unknown to people. If you consider about the entire school education that the students are studying in school, the students studying in schools would be working in sectors which are yet unknown to people. if we consider about 4 million application developers are currently working in India, and application was something that people really did not consider as a career 10, 15 years back, maybe 20 years back, but and they were in school at that time. So, which is why I say that current school students need to be skilled in more futuristic things than they are right now. If you see the situation, we are moving towards artificial intelligence at a very greater speed in everything. In psychology also, people are trying to inculcate artificial intelligence in suicide helplines, in agriculture, in IT sector, in every field. If you see, then artificial intelligence is taking a big leap. But we don't have the skill set yet. Nobody in school is learning coding right now, which is a very important part of AI. So the current education system is teaching you something that you're not, is teaching you something, and you will be working in a sector which does not exist as yet. So you cannot be apprehensive in that case, huh? That I'm studying something and I don't know where will I work. We are studying right now, let's study right now. If we consider always in ourselves in a futuristic sense, then the perceptions that we make would always lead us to, you know, stress only, because you don't know what will happen. At the end of the day, it's just a speculation. It's an apprehension that human potential would be less of an importance than machines. We can wait. Let's wait before speculating on something of this magnitude. Because this can lead to a lot of unemployment sort of things, but then it will also generate possibility of R&D. More and more hands are free for research. We can read more, we can research more.
Well, thank you for addressing all the questions. I would like to thank you on behalf of my audience and my team, my AgriWizard BAU, for giving us time. Thank you, Mr. Avnish Mishra. Would you like to give an end note for all the students?
So the primary end note would be that, like it has been always said, be in the present moment. But you actually need to practice being more in the present. Why? Because the moment you shift from past to future, you are not actually concentrating on what you are facing right now. You are either in the future or in your past. Mostly we dwindle in a swing between these two things. That is what causes stress. Even in situational stress that we talked of, if we see the situational stress is that if I don't speak the right word, then people will laugh. Right? So we are again considering a future situation that people might laugh. People aren't laughing. People might laugh. That's our situational stress that we are facing. So it's us who can change the situation. We can always be in control of the situation and not get stressed out, which is a very important part. And to the students, I would recommend meditation. It's a very important aspect in life. It will always help you gain control of your mind, which will help you fight out the stress that you face in college and in life for you.
Well, thank you. Thank you for giving your precious time.
Thank you.